Welcome to Facebook Live, live at Robbie's house. Here we are in Simi Valley, California, in my home studio. And my special guest is here tonight, and he's over there standing in the corner like a good boy. But you won't see him for a minute because the first thing we do, like it's good to start, no matter what you're doing, if you're going on a trip, if you're going to eat, no matter what you're going to do, the first thing you should always do is say a prayer. And so we're going to lift this evening up to the Lord. We're going to call our resident Pastor Chuck, Pastor Chuck Pearson. Take it away, Pastor Chuck, and lead us in prayer, if you would, my friend.
Hi, guys. I want to show you something that I've had for about 3 weeks. This little thing is a receiver. You may have seen it or advertised on TV. It's Dexcom 6. I'm a diabetic. So I've got a little transmitter on my stomach, and it measures my blood sugar. And so this little thing will tell me when my blood sugar gets too high or too low. Generally, it's not too low, I'll tell you that. But it's really helped me a lot because there are, you know, sometimes there are things that you eat that don't affect you. And I've learned a little bit. I've had it for about 3 weeks, and I've learned a little bit about what I can and can't eat, should or shouldn't eat. Some of that I already knew, but not the effect certain foods would have. For example, if I eat a piece of cake, way high. Potatoes will do that too. But as I said, it's generally not too low when it measures. Anyway, it got me to thinking, what if we all had a little device that every time we were going to do something wrong would beep? There, you know, for example, you're going to tell a lie and there's a beep, beep, you know, and it would catch you. Or, you know, get speed or something like that. You know, what if we had one of those devices? You know, it's probably would be really inconvenient. I've heard people say, well, if God is such a loving God, why didn't he do this? Or why did he allow a Hitler around? Or why did he do that? Or whatever. But does our human nature really want that? Does our human nature really want God stepping in every time we do something wrong? Or do we want it, God to step in when it's convenient for us? And when it's something that would benefit us, I think that's what we want. We kind of want God under our control. The fact is, there is a little mechanism inside of us that warns us when we're going to do something wrong. It's called a conscience. But it's amazing how often we can kind of push that down so that we don't really listen to it. All of us know St. Paul's statement, the good that I want to do, I don't do, and the evil I don't want to do, that's what I do. And that's really the human condition. That's the boat all of us live in. But in Romans chapter 7, St. Paul writes, O wretched man that I am, who will deliver me from this body of death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ our Lord. There are all kinds of things you and I do wrong. But it's not about what we do or what we don't do. It's about what God has done for us and our relationship to him through Jesus Christ our Lord. it's good to have something to remind us of when we're going to fall short. But it's better to know that somebody's already made it up, and to know that He, above all, loves us and has already saved us. Would you pray with me? Father in heaven, we thank You for Your grace and mercy that is new to us every day. There are a lot of concerns all of us have, Father, about stuff that's going on in this world. But You have shown us in the cross of Your Son, Jesus Christ, how much You love us and how much You're committed to us for our good. Help us, Father, to recognize that You are in control in all things. And help us, Father, to praise and glorify You. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Have a great evening.
Hey, my friends. So tonight, 7/20/20. And I'm here in the studio with a friend of mine. About 25 years ago, we were looking for a singer that also played. And this guy came into our world, and he's an extraordinary musician. One of the most talented musicians I've ever met in my whole life. He's a great brother in the Lord, a great guy. And with no further ado, everybody give a nice Jam and Java shout out to Mr. Warren Ham. Hey, brother. Yeah, I see you over there in that. You've been in this studio before, though, haven't you?
A few times.
Yeah. And usually it's back there in the vocal booth. And But tonight we're gonna play some. We're going to play some videos. We're gonna chat. We're gonna reminisce, and we're gonna just have a good time. Warren has an amazing family, and he's got an amazing son named Robert. Robert did a great gift for Warren not too long ago, and it's a video that shows sort of a retrospective of Warren's career. And I thought we would start off to let those of you who may not know Warren Ham or his career, if you've been living under a rock for the last 25, 30 years, we're going to give you a little taste of some of the retrospective of Warren. You have anything you want to say about Robert's video here or anything?
No, it speaks for itself.
Okay. Well, let's roll that clip then. Here's part one of the career on the road, Warren Ham. Goes something like this.
I knew I had a great gig, possibly the best gig of all time. Didn't really hit me until I took my horns in to my horn guy. And the guy goes, "Boy, what's it like to work with a Beatle?" That's when it really hit me. Oh my gosh, I'm playing with a Beatle. How cool is that? I practice every day. I still enjoy pulling out my horns, my harmonicas, and messing around with it.
These days, I'm just grateful to be a working musician in a time where the music business is really, really tough right now. All of the ways to make money has to do with going on the road.
Sunday, famed Beatles drummer,
as you know, my name is Ringo,
takes the stage with his 2016 All-Star Band.
Everybody on stage is a star in their own right.
Sing along to all of your favorite classic hits.
Are you ready to do some singing?
My mom was a piano player. Dad was a bass singer. My brother started getting into guitar around 7, and I started singing around 5. My oldest brother, Norman, he played some piano.
My mom met my dad after he got out of the service. He served in World War II, he was wounded in Belgium.
My parents had a gospel singing group, the Singing Ham Family.
6th grade variety show with my mandolin, and my brother played guitar, and we did Tiger by the Tail by Buck Owens.
Tiger by the tail, it's plain to see.
By that time, the Beatles had come out, and of course, that was the big thing. Everybody was imitating the groups that came out of England at that time.
I think you'll understand when I have
everybody in wood shop or metal shop wanted to have a guitar and play rock and roll, and they needed a singer, and they knew I could sing. And we got a band, why don't you come sing with us?
I was in every garage band in Fort Worth at one point or another. We were a musical family, but we were starting to branch out and go in our different directions.
Norman joined the Navy in the early 70s, and he was in the Navy for 4 years. So a good portion of that time he was overseas. He was in Subic Bay.
And my other brother
had gone back and forth to California a few times, and he had been involved in the Sonny and Cher TV show.
I think I did one semester of college, and then I got the gig with Blood Rock. They invited me to audition, and I guess they auditioned several people, and I ended up getting the gig. Played with them for about 3 or 4 years. Had my first record deal with Capitol Records. Came out to California. We did 2 albums that Capitol released, and the first one was called Passage, and the second one was called Whirlwind Tongues. On Passage, I think we had a semi-hit called Help Is On The Way. A lot of gigs around the country, a lot of festivals, a lot of open for a lot of Grand Funk Railroad and some other people. And I remember we did a gig with Kansas. Kansas actually opened for us, and I got to meet Carrie Livgren for the first time. That turned out to be a connection that I would use in the future. Eventually the band broke up and we all went our separate ways. And then I went back to working with my brother, Bill. He came back to Fort Worth, and we formed the Ham Brothers in the mid-70s. And we did one album, and we recorded a lot down in Houston.
Well, I started playing harmonica first, because I was a singer.
One of my favorite groups to listen to was Paul Butterfield Blues Band that played at Woodstock, and I really liked his style of harmonica playing. And then a couple of years later, I got turned on to Jethro Tull. And recently I met Ian Anderson. And I got the chance to tell him that he inspired me to take up the flute. And he laughed and said, well, most people stop playing the flute because of me. And I laughed. It was really kind of a cool moment, you know, with one of my heroes, you know.
Duff Warnham, Robert did an amazing job on that video.
He did.
Talented guy. Must run in the family. I see you guys watching. Michael John, our buddy Michael John, bass player, is watching. Georgia Higgins Shapiro is watching, the wife of Lee Shapiro. Hi, Georgia. I'm hoping that Lee is with you. And a bunch of guys. All right, guys, so the song that we always play as the bumper music, the opening and closing of Jam and Java, is a song that I wrote back in 1974 when I was living on this island in the South Seas, and I wrote this song called Island Winds. I was actually living in Litchfield, Illinois, but I was dreaming that I was on an island in the South Seas. And on the recording, that's Warren playing the flutes, 3 flutes, and Warren playing the saxophones, I think 3 saxophones, and then a bunch of other guys. So we're going to play, for the first time ever in Jam and Java, we're going to actually play it live with some backing tracks here. And it starts off with my brother Rex playing the bass, and it goes something like this. Thank you. Nice job, Mr. Ham. You still got it, kid. I don't think it ever left him, actually. Let's see what we got here in the Facebook world. Richard McCracklin is watching us. Ava Ham is watching us. You know her, right?
I do.
She's the boss. And great lady you married, I'll tell you that. Shara Sheila Snyder, one of Frankie Valli's biggest fans. No question. She's seen you probably every show you ever played.
Really?
Yeah. That song, and now, I wrote that in 1974. And as I was saying, I'm from Litchfield, Illinois, and I always have to do a shout-out because I love my hometown of Litchfield, Illinois. And you played there.
I did.
The Robinson Brothers' first homecoming concert.
Yes, I did.
And so shout-out to all my friends, our friends in Litchfield. We love you guys, and I was actually there last week. Stay safe, everybody, though. Larry Vasaki. So, what should we talk about? Let's talk about, should we do another video? We've got so many great videos to show you.
Sure, play one.
We could play part two and they could know a little bit more about you.
Okay.
Okay, we're going to play part two of the video that Robert Ham did. And it's really, really cool. So here it is, part two, Warren Ham on the road.
And a couple of years later, I took up the saxophone because it's in the woodwind family along with the flute, so the fingering is similar. Fort Worth and Dallas, and mostly club gigs and stuff. We did some gigs where we opened up for Willie Nelson.
And many people just like me.
And with Leon Russell.
I've sung a lot of songs, I made some bad rhymes.
We got connected up with the group Bread, and we both got hired to be on the tour, and I got my first really good alto saxophone out of that deal, Selmer Mark VI, and we toured around the country. That was a fun tour, great tour. When we were on the road with David Gates and Bread, we played at Santa Monica Civic Auditorium. Now my brother, he knew Cher. She had recently split with Sonny and was starting as a Vegas act. And her girlfriend came to see us. Not too long after that, she contacted us about forming a band for her Vegas act that she was gonna do. It was her first band after her breakup with Sonny.
Cher, a celebration at Caesars.
So we came out to Vegas and started working with Cher. I ended up doing that gig for about 3.5 years.
Get your wine out.
There was a whole horn section with sax players and trumpet players, so they didn't really need any other instrumentation. So I was one of the three background singers. We played all over the world, the south of France. I remember we did a tour to South Africa, the East Coast, the West Coast. Played a lot in Vegas and a lot in Atlantic City. She was bigger than life at that time. It was a real thrill to be able to perform with somebody that magnitude. She was what Madonna and Lady Gaga are now. We did some TV shows. We did the Johnny Carson show a couple of times.
You, I love pretty mama. What you gonna do in those shoes?
I ended up singing in Cher's group, Black Rose. While that I was working with Cher, that I met my wife Ava. She came to see the show. I realized that she lived very close to me in L.A. I had moved from Texas out to L.A. Then we started dating. One thing led to another, and we got engaged and got married and had children and rode off into the sunset, lived happily ever after.
I read the paper and I got the news. I'm so sad. Yeah. You know these times are getting rough, but no matter what I do,
even prayed to heaven above. All I see.
I needed to do something besides Las Vegas. I felt I wanted to try something different. The guys from the rock group Kansas were in LA recording a new album, and they were looking for a singer. I auditioned. I really thought I had nailed it and was going to get the gig. They ended up going with another guy named John Elefante, they really liked his songwriting, and he was a great singer as well. So I thought, well, just missed that one. But they called me and wanted me to be in the band anyway. They wanted me to tour with them because I played multiple instruments.
So I got the opportunity to go out with a true rock and roll band, what I considered one of the great American rock and roll bands. That was the end of my stint with Cher and sort of the beginning of my stint with Kansas. Even though I didn't get the lead singer role, I still jumped at the opportunity to be with the band because I really admired their music. Their big songs were Wayward Son.
Carry on my wayward son. There'll be peace when you are done. May your weary head to rest. Don't you cry no more.
Dust in the Wind. You know, they just had some great songs, and their music was really challenging. They had me playing some keyboard parts along with the sax, flute, harmonica. So I was a busy boy back there. They had me working, learning a lot of stuff, and it was really good for my musical growth.
Ladies and gentlemen, you've been listening to this gentleman play all kinds of instruments up here all night long, including singing. Listen to him play harmonica one more time, Mr. Warren Ham.
Still with Kansas and in 82, Ava was pregnant with our first child, and then Robert was born in December.
I'm in a kind of foolish game. I try to get rich quick, but I'm going the same guy. Reach that hang out down on 42nd Street.
Come on, Robert, play the piano.
Play the piano, Robert.
It wasn't long after that that I did. I started with AD. Carrie and Dave were looking for a way to do progressive rock with a Christian theme, and so they asked me to join a band with them. It was called Carrie Libgren AD.
You look to the east, you look to the west. The gathering sun makes you feel so distressed. You caught in a wind.
We had a record deal. We did a couple of albums. And the music was really fun, very challenging.
Well, it's a marvelous night for a moon dance, with the stars up above in your eyes. A fantabulous night to make romance neath the cover of October skies. And all the leaves on the trees are falling too, the sound of the breezes that blow. And I'm trying to play so calmly with your heartstrings and play soft and low. And all the night's magic seems to whisper and hush. And all that soul moonlight seems to shine in your blush. Can I just have one more moon dance with you, my love? Can I just have one more moon dance with you, my love? To make romance with the cover of October sky. And all leaves on the trees are falling to sound on the breezes and glow. And I'm trying to place a calling of the heart springs and stay soft and low. And all that night's magic seems to whisper and hush. And all that soft moonlight seems to shine. Can you blow? Can I just have one more moon dance with you, my love? Can I just have one more moon dance with you, my love? Can't I just have one more dance with you? Oh, my love.
Oh, yeah, man. Nice. Moon Dance by Van Morrison. And you know, one of our Jam and Java ex-drummers that used to play with us a lot, Gary Malabar, lives in Thousand Oaks. Shout out to you, Mr. Gary Malabar. Great, great drummer. But he played the drums on the record of that.
Wow.
For Van Morrison. Before he moved to New York and was in playing in Van Morrison's band and who played the drums on that, he was in a band with Tony Gala.
Yeah, I remember Gary.
And Tony Gala is watching us right now. Shout out to Tony Gala.
Hey, Tony.
Tony is another bad dude, isn't he?
Yes.
Tony can sing, Tony can play. Tony had a band called Raven out of Buffalo, New York. And the drummer for Raven was Gary Malabar.
Oh, wow.
And then he moved to New York. After Raven, I guess, split up or what? Tony can fill us in on this one of these days. But after that happened, then they ended up all coming out here. And then Gary Malabar ended up producing and playing drums on most of Steve Miller's hits. And he also played with Frankie Valli.
Wow.
It's funny, almost most of the people I know have played with Frankie Valli at some point. So, bravo, great job. Let's do another, well, we have more videos. We do this thing and called Jam for Jesus, and we've done it for 28 years. Warren has been there for well over 20 years now, and you've sung, and you and Rachel have sung, Warren's daughter, and last year, 2019, we did a thing because two of the members of the horn section were in Tower of Power, Doc Kupka and Sal Cracchiola, the trumpet player. And Doc wrote this song, but so I love this song, Digging on James Brown. So we, by the way, if you don't know what Jam for Jesus is, it's a concert that's about 3.5 hours long, consists of about 30 world-class musicians and singers, and we put it all together in one afternoon. It's really by the seat of your pants, and so there's no rehearsal. There's one short run through or talk through of the charts. And Warren, if you remember, I wrote a quick Christmas lyric to Digging on James Brown, the original lyric, and I think you were reading the words, and yeah. You and I were talking about it the day before and stuff, or the day of. I remember it was let's just play the clip. So this is, and the guy who recorded this is our friend Sal Rodriguez, who is the drummer for War. He was sitting in the front row videotaping with his iPhone, and then he posted this on YouTube, so I had to grab it and play it. So this is Digging on James Brown. Take it away.
Now, on this stand-up, Sal, so they remember it. Doc Kupka. Sal Cracchiolo. And so I figured if you got 2/5 of the Tower of Power horn section in your horn section, we've got to do a Tower of Power song. And this is a song that you're going to have to stand up, as Tony would say. Everybody, come on, stand up. You're going to have to, because you can't sit on this next song. It's just too funky.
What? Security.
Okay, here we go. You guys ready?
Yeah!
Are you ready for some Tower of Power song?
Yeah!
One, two, three, four!
Oh,
Hey, now that is some cool stuff. And that was, remember how loosey-goosey that was? Because we were just flying by the seat of our pants, and it really came out good. I love to see Harry Kim and Sal back there doing their moves. And, of course, Doc Kupka, the funkiest Barry sax player on the planet, who wrote that song, playing his Barry sax as only he can. I see a bunch of really cool... Dan Greenlee is watching. Hey, Dan. Larry Visaki from Cleveland. Fred Grichella, the photographer to the stars in L.A., he was watching us. And as I said, Tony Gala, bunch of Litchfield people. What is a Vivino? Mark Lichu, my classmate from Litchfield. Hey, Mark. So we're going to do a song that was written by one of the greatest keyboard players, jazz keyboard players in the world. He's no longer with us, but he was a member of Cannonball Adderley's band when he wrote this song. And then later he started a little band called Weather Report. I've got a cool Weather Report story. When I first moved to California, check this out now. I first moved to California and I got in a band. I really jumped right into all the fusion scene when we first got here, because we were playing with the drummer Alphonse Bouzon, Rex and I, and we were playing in this band. And the percussion, well, actually, this was not Alphonse, this was another band. And the drummer in the band was Manolo Badrino. And Manolo, and I didn't know who he was playing with at the time, and I was talking to him, and I said, and I was a new kid in town, and I was saying, hey, are you playing any other bands around town? He says, yeah, I play in a band called Weather Report. I said, okay. He invited me down to a session they were getting ready to record. And I was at the session where they recorded Birdland. And so I got to meet Joe Zawinul and Wayne Shorter and Jocko and, of course, Alex Acuna and Manolo. And that was one of the memorable nights. And I picked a good night to come, the night that they were recording Birdland. I don't know how many times they recorded it, but... And Joe Zawinul played the Oberheim Modular 8 voice, like that synthesizer over there that people cannot see in the picture. But it's over there. And so this is written by Joe Zawinul. First hit was by Cannonball Adderley, later by a group called the Buckinghams, put words to it out of Chicago, and it's called Mercy, Mercy, Mercy. And it goes. Thank you. All right, so he sings, he plays the flute, he plays the saxophone. What's he going to do next? let's see who's watching us, Brother Warren. Chris Mackamson. I don't know that name. Just another manic Monday. My brother Herb in Texas is watching. You're a Texas boy, aren't you?
Yes.
That's something that you and I have in common.
Yes, excuse me.
By the way, I'm going to do a little bit of an excuse for my friend here whose voice is not with us tonight very much. So he's going to push through like he does. He is the trooper. How?
A little hoarse tonight. I don't know what to.
Yeah.
Yeah, Texas is my home.
Dallas, Texas.
Fort Worth, actually.
You know, for most of us outside, most of the people outside of Texas, Dallas-Fort Worth is kind of the same, but not in Dallas, right?
Nope. Mm-mm. Dallas is called New York with boots.
Yeah, I know that difference, you know.
By Fort Worthians.
Yes. We played in, we had a blessing. We were playing, this is after you were not with us anymore, and I don't know who you were working with because you work with so many people. But we were doing a Frankie show, and you and your mom came by. That was really special. I remember when we would go to Texas and your mom would come around.
Yep.
Now, is she still playing?
She is.
How old is she?
90. She'll be 92 on August the 12th.
Wow. And she's still playing piano?
Yes.
Wow. Warren comes from a musical family, as you probably saw in the video already. But it started out with your mom and dad, I guess. Now, if you go back further, is there music in your family further back?
Not that I know of. No.
And he's passing along the torch. By the way, let's get ready to play. He is passing the torch to his children. Now, Robert played drums, right?
Yes, and Rachel sang.
Rachel, and sing is an understatement. Rachel was, I mean, she's such a gifted young lady. And I used to do a lot of kids' records, and Rachel sang for me a bunch of those kids' records when she was still a kid.
Yep.
But now she's married with kids of her own.
And my brother played the guitar.
That's right. Talent of family. So we have a video clip of Warren and his daughter Rachel singing just an amazing song that was written by David Foster called The Prayer. And this gives you an idea of the talent in the Ham family. So here is The Prayer by Rachel and Warren Ham. Now, how amazing is that? Wow. That's fantastic. Yeah. I mean, that just, it's breathtaking. Is that's so good. What was that language? Was that...
Italian.
I thought that might be what it is. Even though you're not Italian, the Italians, they always are around me, watching over in some way, shape, or form. I can't get away from, Brother Joe is around here, of course. Pete Lauschus is watching. He's an organ player from Mont Olive. He played in a band. When we did the Robinson Brothers thing, and he did a shout-out to you, he said he met you back at the Robinson Brothers thing, so... but he watches almost every... We have people that watch us. There are people from all over the country, of course. Let me know where you're from on here, if you would. And we have people from Germany that watch every week. People from Japan watch every week. Gary Swan is in the house. Their brother Gary, the great Hammond organ player. My hero. And I have his autograph. And we have an Italian from New Jersey. Ray Milanese. Okay, hey, Ray. And, of course, we have Litchfield people. My wife, the CEO of Jam and Java, is watching, Carla.
Oh, she's in Nashville?
She's in Nashville, yep. Robert Crane from San Antonio is watching. Hey, Robert, my cousin. Let's do more of On the Road. That's so fascinating.
Okay.
That way the people can get to know you a little bit more. So this is going to be, again, Robert, that was Warren and Rachel's son. I mean, that was Warren and Rachel's daughter. Warren and Ava's daughter, Rachel, singing that last one. And then the talented Robert put this video together, and here is part three of On the Road. Warren Ham, here we go.
Your personal life takes a hit when you travel that much and, you know, when you're gone from home that much and on the road all the time. Wasn't always easy, you know.
I worked with him before, though. I went to Europe. You talk about cold.
We can.
We played in a place up in Finland, Helsinki, Finland.
All on film, old Pappy.
What happens when you're a touring, traveling musician is you kind of go where the work is at that particular point in time.
It was very difficult to make a living doing Christian music at that time.
And so I had to go back to touring to actually make a living.
And so I left AD.
Here's our little family. Daddy's going away to
rehearse. Daddy's my baby.
Say bye-bye.
Bye.
Give Daddy a kiss.
I heard that Donna Summer was looking for musicians. Bye-bye. I went down and auditioned and got the gig.
At least one from it anyway. Please welcome Donna Summer.
Donna had a big hit with She Works Hard for the Money in 1984. That turned out to be a huge record for her. Consequently, there was a world tour. They had kids in their entourage that you could play with. All the little kids were hanging out. It was a real family affair. Donna Summer is a legend. great singer. I mean, she really was a vocal diva in the truest sense of the word. Well, there was Cher, Diana Ross, Barbara Streisand. There were a few, but Donna was, she could hang with any of them. Oh, she was big time. Donna was huge. And I felt very fortunate and privileged to have worked on and off with her. I mean, whenever she was working and I could be there and be available, I worked on and off with her for 25 years. She took a break, and I heard that Toto was looking for a singer. Again, this was history repeating itself. So I went and I auditioned, and it was one of those situations where, again, I thought I nailed it, and I thought I had the gig as their lead singer.
Ladies and gentlemen, on lead vocals, Joseph Williams.
But it turned out that Joseph Williams got the gig, and a great singer, great guy, totally deserved to get it. And I got called again to be in the band. Their biggest hits are Rosanna, Hold the Line, and Africa. That experience being in that band, just the musicianship was on a real high level. That was back when Jeff Porcaro was still alive, and David Page and Steve Lukather and Steve Porcaro. And
on guitar, Steve Lukather.
Just a great band, a great experience to be in. Great musicians. I toured a lot with Toto in Japan and Europe.
On sax and backgrounds, flute, harp, Mr. Warren Hay.
Just varied. I mean, you got to where you were living on the road, you know, living out of a suitcase. I just kind of learned to live that way when I was on the road, you know. And my daughter Rachel came along in '87, March of.
You can get rid of those hiccups.
It was after that time that I, when Rachel was a toddler, that we began working with Amy Grant and got on that big Lead Beyond tour with Amy Grant.
Let's go get the camera ready.
Worked a couple of years with her. Really long, huge tour, a worldwide tour with Amy. They were filling up stadiums and concert halls. Michael W. Smith was on that tour and was the opening act and part of Amy's band. And Amy Grant was doing big venues in the U.S. She was huge at that time. Her record that she did at that time was called Lead Me On, and that was the name of the tour.
You sit there, then you just let these songs roll over you, okay? Okay, this next one is another song from my new record, Lead Me On, and this one is The Story of My Life.
And that whole group of people was really good to me.
Hi, Robert.
Thank you.
singing and playing saxophone, Mr. Warren Hand.
But all of these were working situations that were seasons of in my life, you know, and they couldn't last forever because that's just not the nature of the business.
People get ready, there's a train coming. You don't need no baggage, you just get on. Faith to hear the diesel coming. You don't need no ticket, you just thank the Lord. People get ready, there's a train to Jordan, picking up passengers from coast to coast. Now faith is the key, open the doors and board them. There's hope for all among those most loved. There's a train coming. You don't need no baggage. You just get on board. All you need is faith to hear the diesel humming. You don't. You just thank the Lord. Now you don't need no ticket. You just thank the Lord.
Nice. We gotta shorten that mic cable, isn't it? Or something, is it tight all the way in there?
Yeah.
Clipped out on us a couple times. People Get Ready, written by the great Curtis Mayfield. I was in a band way back in a million years ago called Seven from Litchfield in Southern Illinois. And we got signed to Curtis Mayfield's label, Kurtom Records. And Curtis came down to our rehearsals, and he was going to write our songs and produce us. And I thought, we're on our way, man. But such is the way things happen. And the band broke up when during this on stage one time the guitar player punched the singer in the mouth.
That's never good.
No,
I've never seen that go well.
No, it's bad when that happens. Yeah. So that was, let's see who's watching. Kathy Nelson from church is watching. Trinity, by the way, my home church where I'm the minister of music is Trinity Lutheran Church in Simi Valley, California. And Warren has been coming to sing at that church with me ever since I've been there. And he's been sort of a semi-regular singer, musician there with us in a variety of places. Ask Warren about Greece, Gary Swan says. Should we ask Warren about Greece?
Well, what about it?
I know. I think Gary has this mixed up because great Frankie Valli sang Greece.
Yeah.
Olivia Newton-John was in Greece.
Yes.
And she sang all the other songs in Greece.
And I did the duet with her.
And you did. I bet we have a clip of that, don't we?
I think that's what he's talking about, maybe.
I'll bet that's what Gary... All right, well, let's see. Let's see if you... This is Warren singing the duet, and it's... What's the name of the song?
You're the One That I Want.
All right, here it goes. Right. You're a man of many talents. Dancing too, brother.
Well, you know, two left feet, but I give it my best shot.
Did you have to work a lot on the dancing choreography stuff?
No, not once I learned the choreography, it wasn't difficult. You know, I just, you know.
Who taught you the choreography?
She did, actually.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. And of course, Frankie Valli sang the title song for that
movie. He did.
We did a show together. This was when you were working. I got a chance to see you in Vegas because we were playing across the street, and I went over to watch your show, and that was such a kick to see you working with Olivia. And then we did a show because they were exploring the idea of Frankie Valli and Olivia touring together.
Yeah.
And we did that show together up north, outdoors somewhere, and that was a kick to work that show with you, but you were working with Olivia.
Yeah, in Lincoln, that was up in by Sacramento.
Yeah, up north somewhere. So now, of course, the musicians. My brother has been the bass player for Frankie Valli he was the bass player for 25 years, and in the band when you were in the band back in the 90s, the band was you and me and Rex and Zorro, the inimitable Zorro on drums. Who just played with? He did a thing for me last week too, which was pretty cool. Zorro is a monster.
What was it that was? You sent it to me, right? I mean,
no, I don't know if I did. Oh yeah, you played on it. Duh! It was that Mandy Pinto song that we did.
Yes, was that Zorro? That's Zorro's what I thought.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
And then who else was? Oh, Fino. How could I forget Fino?
How could you?
I could never forget Fino because Fino plays almost everything that I do. Fino is the guitar player.
Speaking of Fino, where is Fino tonight?
Fino, he's got something he wants to say to you. I know that. Hey, that was a good segue. I'm impressed.
Warren Ham, whew. There's a heavy, talented guy right there. I don't care if he's singing, playing, no matter what instrument, you will find none better. I first met Warren and Frankie Valli in the Four Seasons when we were in the band. What a great bandmate and friend. Warren is probably the best all-around musician singer I've ever known. And he's toured with such big stars as Kansas, Cher, Olivia Newton-John, Toto, Donna Summer, of course, our favorite Frankie Valli, and my favorite rock drummer Ringo. And you were the one Olivia Newton-John wanted to sing and dance with. That's the best. And you got to play crayons with Donna Summer. That's pretty cool. So what an honor it is to know you, Warren, and to perform with you. I hope we get to do it soon. And, you know, this was supposed to be kind of a roast, but it's hard to roast somebody you really love. But I thought of something very, very nice to close it out with. I thought a lot about this. And what do you call a man who's a true rock and roll icon? What do you call a man whose songs will live in the hearts of millions of fans? Who do you call a man who has inspired countless musicians to pursue their dreams of making a difference in the world? You call that man John Lennon. But we love you, Warren. Take care, buddy. Out. Peace and love. Peace and love.
Thanks. I want that crazy lid.
Yeah. He's got quite a hat.
Beautiful.
And then when you get Fino and Rex together, it's like, I don't know, man. It's like I have to separate those guys. Well, as a matter of fact, Rex has something.
I heard that Rex has been taking something for his receding hairline.
Yeah, it has been receding for a long time, but now I think since this pandemic started, things are working.
He just let it grow?
He just let it grow.
Okay.
You're going to see right here.
Hello, Rex Robinson here. I want to give a shout out to my good friend Warren Ham. Warren Ham is one of the most talented cats I've ever met. Heck, he's almost as talented as me. As you can see, during this pandemic, I have not been able to get a good haircut. But anyway, enjoy listening to Warren Ham tonight. And Warren, I have a question for you. How come you never put the Robinson Brothers Band on your resume?
All right. Yeah, his hair is starting to grow out. Maybe
it's amazing. And the color.
Yeah.
It's his original color, man. I can't believe it.
I remember one time, and I think this probably depicts it. We were rehearsing, and whenever Rex and Fino, I could never get anything done when Rex and Fino were together. And I remember stopping the rehearsal saying, "What is this, a clown band?" And I'm afraid it was a clown band. It was a good band, but
we had some good times, so we did.
And we have another old bandmate of yours that wants to do a shout out too. This guy is from Norway.
Oh.
Hey, Warren. Jens Wendelbo here. Man, long time since we went out with Donna Summer on tour. But I hope you guys are doing great, and I hear you're going to be jamming with Robbie Robinson tonight. So have some fun and play one for me. All right? Take care now.
All right. Jens Wendelbo, great trombone player, great music director. He, whenever we go back east, he's one of the main guys that we use on in Frankie Valli's concerts, and he and I become great buddies. And yeah. He's the only guy I know, Jens, this is a shout-out to you, Brother Wins, Jens. He's the only guy I know that has written his own symphony and had it recorded.
Wow.
Yeah, pretty impressive. But he associated with Donna for years.
Yes, right? Many, many years, about 25 years.
One of my favorite songs of all time is called What a Friend We Have in Jesus. And we're going to do our version. So Warren, of course, as you...
I'll start with the harp.
Warren grew up playing these hymns with his mom and his dad, right?
You said F, right?
You know, it's good to have friends in high places.
The highest.
That is the highest, isn't it? Above every name, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. All right, let's see what our Jam and Java Facebook peeps are saying. Dennis Schwartz is watching us. Scott, my brother from Columbus, is watching. Shout out from Ohio. Jerry Hayes, hi from Southern California. Jack Mattson, he's a regular at Jam and Java. And we've got, well, you know what? Can we get Amazing Grace up next? I mentioned that you played at Trinity many times with us. This past Easter, you and Warren and I, this past Easter, Warren and I did a duet of one of the great hymns of faith, Amazing Grace. And God's riches at Christ's expense, Amazing Grace. If you want to know what grace is all about, I mean, because we don't deserve to be saved, because we deserve to have eternal punishment. If you've sinned once, the bad news is this. If you sin one time, that's enough to send you to hell, according to the Bible. That's not my words. That's the Bible. That's what the Bible teaches. But by God's amazing grace, Jesus Christ went to that cross for each one of us and died for our sins. Grace, God's riches at Christ's expense. And all you got to do is believe in him and you shall be saved.
Amen.
So Warren and I did this this duet of Amazing Grace. Let's just play that duet. This is us this last Easter, Trinity. This is, of course, virtual. We were in the pandemic stage where we were doing the church services virtual. I was actually in the church playing my Hammond organ there, and you were in your house playing your harmonica and singing and doing all the stuff that you do. So here it is, Amazing Grace.
Ha ha ha!
shining as the sun. We've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. Oh, than when we first begun. Than when
let's do a song by Stanley Turrentine. What do you think?
Let's do it. Let me start. Let me give an intro.
Thank you.
Sugar, Sugar, Sugar. Not Sugar, Sugar, Sugar by the Archies, but Sugar by a Stanley Turrentine. Cool stuff. What do we got here on the... my wife says, reach up, reach in, and reach out. That is the theme of our Trinity Lutheran Church. That is our motto. That is our mission statement. Reach up to Christ. Reach in, and then reach out to the world. And that's what we do, share the gospel. Just like you were singing Amazing Grace at Trinity, and that was so cool when that you did that. Let's do... I think we should play more video.
Okay.
Some more of the Warren Ham on the road. Take it away.
And then I came back and worked with Donna in the early 90s.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Donna Summer. Spring was never waiting for us, dear. It ran one step ahead as we followed it. The dance. Never fell out, she never will. Never fell out
At that point, I was starting to get road weary, tired of being on the road.
There's Warren coming.
So I decided to come off the road and not do it anymore for a while. Well, I did gigs in town, you know. I did everything from club gigs to weddings to bar mitzvahs.
Thank you very much. The best band ever, the Ham Brothers.
After about 3 or 4 years of that, I realized that yeah, no, I didn't want to be out of the music business because that was what I do and that's what I was able to make the best living at. So I was looking for a gig again. And I had been sounded by Toto's old manager about working with Olivia Newton-John. And 6 months later, I got the call. Yeah, we could use you if you're still available and interested. And that's how that happened.
Tell me more, did you get very far?
Tell me more, like does he have a car? Uh-huh.
You've heard, he must play 50 million instruments back there. I don't know how he does it, Mr. Warren Ham.
That was the beginning of a long relationship. Another legend, big time, world star, world class star, and I ended up working with Olivia on and off for about 13 years. Play all my instruments, sing background with the other two background singers, and they needed somebody to do the duet with her on the Grease medley. And of course that was a big hit. Thrilled to be able to get to do that with her. We played all over the world. We played in Vegas, we played in Atlantic City, we played, you know, England, we played in Australia, Japan. I got to sing that song with her every night. It was always a real thrill to do it. Olivia's a very, very sweet, special person, very generous. Took us all over the world with her, you know. And in 2014, I got a Facebook message from Steve Lukather that said, call me immediately. And so I thought, well, I wonder what this is about. So I called him. I found out that Ringo Starr was looking for somebody that did exactly what I do, singing and playing saxophone, flute, percussion, So the next thing I know, I'm playing in Ringo Starr's All-Star Band. That really blew my mind, because here I am after a long career with many, many great artists at Here's the Pinnacle, you know. It was just a real shocker in a good way. And it's been a great ride with Ringo. I mean, he's just so funny and generous, the sweetest guy ever, really genuine. And he's exactly who his persona says that he is. He's Mr. Peace and Love.
We all live in a yellow submarine. A yellow submarine. A yellow submarine. We all live in a yellow submarine.
A yellow submarine. A yellow submarine.
Steve, look at that.
Not to mention one of the greatest rock and roll drummers of all time. I mean,
I wanna be your lover, baby. I wanna be your man. I wanna be your lover, baby. I wanna be your man. Love you like no other, baby, like no other can.
I'm so thrilled to be in that situation, playing with him, and not to mention all the other great all-star musicians that are in the band. Todd Rundgren, Richard Page, Greg Raleigh, of course Steve Lukather, Colin Hay, Hamish Stewart. We had to cancel this year because of the coronavirus. We're still planning to go back out in 2021. Well, I'm gonna be right there in the middle of it. Not only am I working with Ringo, but I'm working with Toto again too. I was with them back in the 80s, and it was a chance to get back with them. Highs and lows in this business, and we have big disappointments. I had some disappointments in my career, that I didn't get a certain gig when I wanted to get it. I look back, and some of the things that I was denied turned out to be a blessing in disguise. Now that I look back at it, it's like things turned out the way they were supposed to turn out. I'm still here, and I'm still relatively healthy, and I'm still working. Had a great run, and I thank God. Still doing my thing. I've been married to my wife for 38 years. My children are grown, and they're doing their thing. I don't dwell too much on what I deserve and what I don't deserve, because it's really not about that. I feel very richly blessed to have led the life that I've led.
Our crazy ham family.
I want some Blood Rock merch. Back then.
So when did you grow up in this? Which one is it?
It's this blue.
blue house here.
See the blue house?
Is this up here too?
This is Dad's first house. Christmas passed on Veterans Day. He was in the Navy. This is Old Pappy, World War II veteran. We have the same birthday.
Blessed man, my brother.
Yes, I am. I really am.
Wonderful family.
Thanks. That was my brother on guitar, by the way.
Boy, he sounds great.
William is his name. Yeah, he plays all styles. And he studied classical guitar with James Eddy, who studied with Andre Segovia.
Wow.
So it's like a grandchild of Andre Segovia. He can really play that style, as well as blues and jazz. And he's a wonderful musician.
And I remember when I worked with you on your record back in 1990. I saw the thing tracks down here, 1999, a couple of years ago. But Bill played on that record too.
He did. Played on a few numbers on it, three or four.
People, can they still get that record somewhere? Is it on CD Baby or anything?
I think so. I think it's on CD Baby.
It's called
Come On Children.
Come On Children. Yeah, that's a great record.
You stumped me. It was 2000.
Yeah, only 20 years ago.
Well,
seems like yesterday to me. It's amazing because I'm only 19 years old and that was 20 years ago.
Yeah, I know.
It's funny how that works, the new math. Let's see.
Let's close it out with this one. You wanna?
Yeah, we got a shout out here. Fino Roverado says hi all the way from Northridge.
Hey, Fino.
Yep. All right, guys. I got to thank you for being here.
Oh, my pleasure. My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for being had, as they say. It's been really special to have you here because you're a dear friend, dear brother, and an amazing musical colleague and musical talent and all that kind of stuff. And
thanks.
It's
likewise.
Always great to do music with you, my
always
friend.
Always great to be with you. Thanks for having me.
So, we'll close it out with this. Now, this old hymn, you got started. So how old were you when your mom was playing hymns and you were a kid?
5 years old, singing gospel music.
Wow.
So that's my roots. Gospel music, Southern gospel music is my roots.
Wow. You probably did this song somewhere back in those days.
Yep.
Well, let's do it.
And many times since.
Let it be, dear Lord, let it be. By the way, I'm convinced that Paul McCartney must have heard this hymn somewhere along the line when he wrote, let it be, let it be, let it be, but I digress. All right, well, thanks again, Warren, for coming. We're going to play one more song to take this out, and it's a song that you sang at Trinity Lutheran, that you played at Trinity Lutheran. It's an old gospel song called Praise Him, and it's got some neat surprises. The band that we did for that, again, this is all virtual. It's you singing the lead, Ray Reynolds and Tony Galla singing along with us, and Olivia Barker is singing.
Oh, yeah.
And then Harry Kim is playing the trumpet, and then we have on trombone Robbie Hioki from Brian Setzer Orchestra, and Robbie Hioki is also playing the tuba. Well, it's a red sousaphone, actually. So,
right.
This is not your father's Lutheran church. This is Trinity Lutheran Church, and this is one of our worship services. So let's play that thing. We're going to go out with this. Praise Him. Thank you all for coming back out to Jam and Java. Any shout out to our Jam and Java peeps out there?
Shout out. We'll see you next time.
Next time. And on next week, I'm not sure what the show is going to be. I think it might. Baseball season starts this coming weekend. And I'm going to do a baseball themed show. Maybe next Monday, but maybe 2 weeks. We'll see. And if it's not a baseball, I don't know who's going to be out there. Who knows? It's always a surprise with this Jam and Java stuff. So here we go. Praise Him. God bless each and every one of you. Thank you for watching and hanging with us. Come and see us next Monday. Bye.
Praise Him. Praise Him. Praise Him in the morning. Praise Him in the noontime. Praise Him when the sun goes.
praise him in the morning, praise him in the noontime, praise him, praise him, praise him when the sun goes down. Love him, love him, love him in the morning, love him in the noontime.
Thank you. Thank you.